on the remark by the previous gentleman that stayed here, the nurse from Gary, thanks, I'm sorry, but a few weeks ago, there was an article in Pravda by Vladimir Putin of Russia, expressing the disbelief and consternation of the Russian people that America is adopting Marxism. He said, are you people crazy? We tried that, it doesn't work. And the irony of a former KGB agent expressing disbelief at our willingness to give up our freedom was evident. I mean, it was just incredible. To me, though, there's an element of fraud in this whole debate. I am one of those so-called 46 million that is uninsured. But nobody has addressed my reason for being uninsured. I choose to be uninsured. It's not a matter of finances. I have the best policy that's available if I wanted it. I don't want any of them because I don't want to be restricted to what the healthcare industry has to offer me. I'm 60 years old. I can still do anything I ever did when I was 18, but I take care of myself. I exercise regularly. I eat right. I pray for good health. I take care of myself. There are all kinds of ways to cure the diseases that are hurting so many of us that don't involve medicines. This whole debate is going to be a winner for the medical industry and the pharmaceutical industry either way. Has anybody noticed that 5 of every 6 commercials in prime time now is a drug commercial? To me, if the debate was healthy, we'd be talking about how to get Americans weaned off of the medical care system altogether. There is a doctor, for example, in New Orleans, Dr. Mary. I know him personally. He's cured almost every cancer patient that's ever been sent to him for 20 years. He doesn't use chemotherapy or radiation. He injects with vitamin C, anywhere from 100,000 to 400,000 milligrams of vitamin C. 3 weeks' time on average, they have no cancer. 3 weeks is the average cure time. They don't lose their hair. They don't lose their appetite. They don't lose their energy. Shouldn't the focus be on these methods that work without the consequences? That's all I've got to say. I don't want the medical insurance because I don't want what the medical industry has to offer me. Thank you. I'll take care of myself, okay?
Senator Vitter, I see in here that you... Oh, I'm sorry. I'm Meredith Henson, and I'm from Central. I see in here that you are introducing a bill to try to get everybody in Congress and the Senate to also be involved in this health care reform. Now, I'm all for health care reform, but if this is such good health care reform, how come those folks way up there, how come they're not going to be participating in this? If it's so good for us, why should we be with them?
You're right, Marianne, that's the exact point of my bill, which is going to be the first amendment I bring on the floor of the Senate during this debate. And it's going to be very simple. It's going to say whatever government option there is in the bill, whatever there is, anything like it, every member of the U.S. House, every member of the U.S. Senate has to be in that option, no other choice. Capital, no special privileges at military hospitals, just that government option, nothing else.